Hello students, welcome to the EPG Pathshala. My name is Dr. Rajeshwari Sinha, and in today's lecture we are going to learn about the structure and function of complex carbohydrates. Today's lecture will be comprised of introduction about complex carbohydrates. There are a variety of complex carbohydrates known in nature. In this lecture we are going to learn about many of them. We will also be going to learn about the various sources of these complex carbohydrates. Further, we look at a description about their structure and function in various cell functioning as well as industrial applications. We hope you have an enjoyable time listening to this lecture on complex carbohydrates. In this slide, we have a look at the concept map that will be followed in this modules. We see that complex carbohydrates are composed of polysaccharides, which are more than 10 monosaccharide units linked with glycosidic bonds. These are of two types, homopolysaccharides and heteropolysaccharides. Homopolysaccharides are starch, cellulose and inulin as examples. Heteropolysaccharides examples include glycoproteins, glycolipids, hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate, gangliosides, etc. Complex carbohydrates. As discussed earlier, carbohydrates may present as mono, di, oligo and polysaccharide forms. They may be classified as complex and simple on the basis of their composition and impact on metabolism. Simple sugars are those which get converted into energy within short period, whereas complex ones last longer. Complex carbohydrates are composed of sugar molecules and may be linked in branched like coil structure or associated with any non-carbohydrate chemical moieties, for example, glycoproteins and other sugar derivatives. They are rich in fiber, vitamins and minerals which are beneficial for health. They are well abundant in whole plant grains like wheat, barley, oats, green vegetables, potatoes, sweet potatoes, corn, pumpkin, beans, lentils, peas, etc. Properties of complex carbohydrates. Most of the complex carbohydrates, oligosaccharides and polysaccharides, unlike monosaccharides, are insoluble in water and acts as dietary fibers because they are indigestible and cannot be absorbed in human small intestine. Such fibers are fermented by the microorganisms present into the human colon. Carbohydrates as such play a variety of roles in nutrition, physiological functions and in signal transduction pathways, therefore to bring diversified functionality, many modifications have been brought by nature in it. They may be present in the form of glycoproteins, glycolipids, polysaccharides, oligosaccharides, attached to membrane proteins and gangliosides, etc. There is no defined classification of this group of carbohydrates and therefore described individually in this module as follows. Sialic acid. Sialic acids are derivatives of sugars and play an important role in physical and mental well-being of living beings. They are the sugar amines which have important function in neurological development. Sialic acid is a derivative of neuraminic acid. It is also called N-acetylmuramic acid or NANA. They are commonly present in animal tissues and to a lesser extent reported in some other organisms also. Human brain contains the highest concentration of sialic acid, where it has an important function in structure of the gangliosides and neural transmissions. Generally, sialic acid class of compounds found associated with oligosaccharide chains of complex carbohydrates like glycoproteins and glycolipids, where it occupies the non-reducing end of the carbohydrate molecules and provides important function to the complex. Another example of sialic acid is chitin, a hard outer skeleton of arthropods known as N-acetyl-D-glucosamine, which protects them from the external world. This slide shows the structure of sialic acid or N-acetyl-muramic acid. Galactosamine and glucosamine. Galactosamine is a derivative of galactose. It is a hexosamine having molecular formula C6H13NO5. The amino sugar is present as the component of hormones involved in reproductive processes like follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. This carbohydrate derivative is a hepatotoxic agent, and the main sources of galactosamine are bovine, meat and red algae. Glucose aminoglycans, which are the precursor of glucosamines, are the main component of joint cartilages and can be helpful in the osteoarthritis and osteoporosis treatment. Oligosaccharides of glycoproteins and glycolipids. There are some carbohydrate moieties which get covalently attached with specific proteins or membrane lipids. These oligosaccharide residues may be linear or branched chains. Most of the time, they include modified sugar such as acetylglucosamine, etc. They can be N-linked or O-linked. O-linked oligosaccharides have an important function in recognition and interaction. N-acetylglucosamine is a common O-linked glycosylation found in protein and amino acid residues containing a hydroxyl group. These molecules play an important role in cell's protein regulation. N-linked glycosylation. N-linked glycosylation of the proteins help them to attain complex and branched structure. In starting, N-acetylglucosamine gets linked through asparagine residues side chain of a protein. Along with that, more monosaccharide units are added and removed from the oligosaccharide chain to modify it, and hence resulting a characteristic branched complex structure. Most of the secretory proteins have N-linked glycosylation. There are many genetic diseases also which are associated with the defect in synthesis and modification of these oligosaccharides linked with specific proteins. These oligosaccharide components of the complex generally present in extracellular space and participates in signaling and cell-cell communication. They also provide protective environment by forming a layer on some cell surfaces. Students, we have just looked at a few complex carbohydrates, namely sialic acid, galactosamine and glucosamine, and also looked at some of their properties and structure. The concept of N-linked glycosylation and O-linked glycosylation was also discussed briefly. In the next few slides, we are going to look at examples of several other types of complex carbohydrates along with their structures and specific roles. At the end, we will also look at the biological functions of these complex carbohydrates. Sucralose. It is a sucrose derivative known as Splenda. Sucrose derivative sucralose is 600 times sweeter than sucrose. Its structure is very much similar to sucrose molecule. In sucralose, hydroxyl groups are substituted by chloride atoms. Sucralose is calorie free since the body did not recognize it as a sugar, and therefore it is not broken down for getting energy. It can be used by diabetic patients. Dextran. This is another polysaccharide which is very much similar to amylopectin. In dextran, its main chain are made up of 1 to 6 alpha glycosidic linkages, whereas its side chain are connected from chain by 1 to 3 alpha or 1 to 4 alpha linkages. Dextran is a bacterial product which forms film on teeth called plaque. Dextran is commercially used in food additives and lacquers. Inulin. Inulin is a form of carbohydrate storage molecules found in plants, example bananas, chicory and onions, along with the starch. They are the polymers of fructose with a glucose molecule at its terminal. Oligofructose is also a polymer of fructose having structure similar as inulin and contains 10 or fewer fructose units than inulin. Solubility of inulin is less than the oligofructose and its texture is smooth and creamy. Both inulin and oligofructose is non-digestible in the human intestine, and therefore they are fermented by intestinal microflora and get converted into lactate and short-chain fatty acids. These polysaccharides are used to replace in food items to reduce the calories. Arabinoxylan. Arabinoxylan is also a complex polysaccharide present in wheat and another grains bran. It is composed of L-arabinofuranose and xylose changed with 1 to 2 alpha and or 1 to 3 alpha linkages randomly. Arabinoxylan is used in baking industries due to its arabinose unit, which can bind with water molecules and produces viscous compound that effective in glass bubble retention, dough consistency, and in final texture of the product. Chitin. This is a complex carbohydrate having long chain polymeric structure of N-acetyl D-glucosamine. It is well abundant in fungal cell wall and external covering of arthropods or lower animals. It is derivative of cellulose and formed after replacement of OH group at the C2 position of glucose units with the acetamido group. Beta-glucans. Beta-glucans is also having similar structure like cellulose. It consists of straight unbranched polymeric structure containing beta-D-glucose subunits. Only difference is that there is 1 to 3 beta linkage present after every 3 or 4 1 to 4 beta linkages between the beta-D glucose chains. It forms long cylindrical structure consisting of about 250,000 glucose units. Bran of grains is a good source of beta-glucans and it is useful in reducing the cholesterol level. Glycosaminoglycans. These are the complex carbohydrates generally found in lubricating fluids, heart valve, cartilages and synovial fluids. It is also an unbranched long chain polysaccharide with repeating disaccharide units of amino sugars, namely N-acetylgalactosamine and N-acetylglucosamine along with uronic acid, for example, hyaluronic acid, heparin and chondroitin sulfate, etc. Chondroitin sulfate. This is a polymer of beta-D glucouronate and N-acetylgalactosamine 4-sulfate linked with the C3 atom. Heparin, on the other hand, is a mixture of complex polysaccharides with anticoagulant activity and varies in the degree of sulfation of its monosaccharide units. Agar and carrageenan. Agar is a polymer of disaccharide unit known as agarobiose, consisting of D-galactose and 3,6-anhydro L-galactose. Carrageenan structure has sulfate groups in some places along with hydroxyl groups. Both are used as thickening and gelling agents in various food products. Alginates. Alginates is also a product from seaweeds Macrocystis pyrifera, also known as giant kelp. It consists of beta-D manouronic and alpha-L gulouronic acids linked with 1 to 4 alpha linkages. These units are randomly arranged in a chain. Alginate is water-insoluble, used as gelling and thickening agents. Galactomannan. Galactomannans are the complex carbohydrates found in a number of vegetable gums. It consists of a mannose backbone linked with 1 to 4 beta and galactose side chain attached with 1 to 6 alpha linkages. These are used in thickening agents in food products. It is also known as guaran, present in seeds of guar gum. Pectin. Pectin is a complex carbohydrate present in the plant cell walls. It is a methylated ester made up of 300 to 1000 galactouronic acids linked with 1 to 4 alpha linkages. Pectins have 3 methyl ester forms for every 2 carboxyl groups, has 60 degree of esterification, generally known as DE60 pectin. It has a wide application in food industries as a food preservative and jellies. The xanthan gum is the complex carbohydrate produced by the bacterium Xanthomonas campestris. It is having cellulose kind of backbone of beta-D glucose in which every second glucose unit is connected with a trisaccharide unit consisting of mannose, glucouronic acid and mannose. Its side chain contains a negatively charged carboxyl group which forms a viscous solution when mixed with water. Glucomannan. Glucomannan found in tubers of Amorphophallus konjac and have very low calories content. It is a soluble polysaccharide and used in absorbent articles such as disposable diapers and napkins. Its components are glucose and mannose linked together by 1 to 4 beta linkages in 5:8 ratio. It has a polymeric repeating unit having the provided sequence. Glucose-glucose, mannan-mannan, glucose, mannan, 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 glucose, glucose, mannan. Mucins. Mucins are highly glycosylated proteins having a high molecular weight produced by epithelial cells. It is a gel-like substance which functions as a lubricant and signaling molecules. Mucin monomers are made up of a rod-shaped apomucin core which is post-translationally modified by glycosylation. This heavy glycosylation of mucins provides them good water-holding capacity and protects them from proteolysis. Hyaluronic acid produced by streptococci and a component of extracellular matrix also present in skin and joints. It is a class of anionic glycosaminoglycans made up of disaccharide repeating units. In bacteria, it forms an outer covering which acts as an adhesion for attachment with cell surfaces of the target cell. Polysaccharide K and polysaccharide peptide, namely PSK and PSP. These are the polysaccharides which are protein bound and have been found in mushrooms. These protein contains monosaccharides linked with 1 to 4 alpha and 1 to 3 beta glucosidic linkages, and their peptidyl component mainly consists of glutamic and aspartic acid. PSK mainly contains fructose sugar, whereas PSP contains rhamnose and arabinose. Glycosphingolipids. It is a group of glycolipids made up of amino alcohol sphingosine. They are generally considered as the sphingolipids which contain carbohydrate molecule. They are of three types: cerebrosides, gangliosides and globosides. Glycosphingolipids are generally present on the cell surface where they help the cells to interact with their surroundings. They act as markers for the cell and control the cell-cell interaction. Gangliosides. These are complex carbohydrates composed of glycosphingolipids and sialic acids linked with a sugar change. NEU-NAC, which is a derivative of sialic acid, forms the head of gangliosides. They are mainly found in nervous system, containing 6% of the total phospholipids. Cerebrosides. Cerebrosides, also known as monoglycosyl ceramides, are glycosphingolipids and act as an important component of animal muscle and nerve cells. They are the complex ceramide and sugar molecules. There are two major types of cerebrosides, glucocerebrosides and galactocerebrosides, and they are typically present in neural tissues. Proteoglycans are heavily glycosylated proteins. The basic structure of proteoglycan is made up of proteins with serine residue through which glycosaminoglycans chains are attached through a tetrasaccharide bridge. The carbohydrate chains are linear and negatively charged due to the presence of uronic acid or sulfate groups. In proteoglycan, glycosaminoglycans constitute 95% of the total weight of proteoglycans. It is an important component of extracellular matrix and connective tissues, for example, aggrecan. It also acts as a lubricant for joints. Aggrecan is also found in brain and plays an important role in central nervous system by inhibiting growth and interaction of neurons. There are some reports which show that aggrecan also contributes in dementia and loss of neurons. 1 to 3 beta glucans. These are homopolymers of glucose. The main source of 1 to 3 linked beta glucans are fungi. Soluble glucans occurs in the form of triple helix in aqueous solution, whereas solubility of insoluble glucans can be improved by phosphorylation and amination. Biological function of complex carbohydrates. Energy storage molecule. Carbohydrate is misconceptually considered to be the main reason behind obesity problem, but it acts as a long-lasting and sustained energy source for our body. Structural functions. Glycoproteins, which are also complex carbohydrates, play an important role in various cellular processes of higher organisms. Collagen is another important complex carbohydrate which is present in extracellular matrix and in cartilages as a structural element. The binding between glycosaminoglycans and other extracellular macromolecules contributes significantly to the structural organization of connective tissue matrix. Immunological function. Mucins, which act as lubricants in our body, have a protective function. Immunoglobulins, ABO group antigen of the blood, histocompatibility antigens and interferons come under complex carbohydrates which belong to glycoprotein class. Acts as signaling molecules. Many proteins such as fetuin, ceruloplasmin and transferrin and several other hormones like chorionic gonadotropin and thyrotropin in humans are glycoproteins in nature. Receptors on cell surfaces. Lectin is a protein which can bind with the cellular membrane. It contains binding sites for carbohydrates due to which they can form glycoconjugates on the membrane and help in cell-cell interactions. Detection of diseases. Glycosphingolipids reported to inhibit the mitogenic response of cell growth factors by modulating cell surface receptors. The alterations in the glycosphingolipids pattern show oncogenic transformation. Function as an anticoagulant. Heparin interacts with several plasma proteins, including clotting factors 9 and 11, and antithrombin 3 acts as an anticoagulant. Regulation of cell growth. Proteoglycans involved in the cell growth regulation through nuclear effects on structure of chromatin by DNA polymerase activation, cell-cell communication, and the cell surface receptors shedding. Precursor molecules. Glycosphingolipids are present in the blood plasma and the brain, which is a complex carbohydrate, as precursors for other complex glycosphingolipids. We have now come to the end of this lecture. Thank you for being there with us. Let us now summarize what we have learned in this lecture briefly. Complex carbohydrates are composed of a mixture of sugar molecules and may be linked in branched-like coil structure or associated with any non-carbohydrate chemical moiety, for example, glycoproteins and other sugar derivatives. Complex carbohydrates are insoluble in water and acts as dietary fibers. Carbohydrates as such play a variety of roles in nutrition, physiological functions, and in signal transduction pathways. They may be present in the form of glycoproteins, glycolipids, polysaccharides, oligosaccharides attached to the membrane proteins and gangliosides. Some carbohydrate moieties which get covalently attached with specific proteins or membrane lipids. These oligosaccharide residues may be linear or branched chain and can be O-linked or N-linked. Examples of some complex carbohydrates which we studied today include sialic acid, galactosamine, glucosamine, sucralose, dextran, inulin, arabinoxylan, chitin, beta-glucan, agar, carrageenan, glycosaminoglycans, alginates, galactomannans, glucomannans, pectin, xanthan gum, mucin, hyaluronic acid, gangliosides, glycosphingolipids, cerebrosides, proteoglycans, and glucans. Complex carbohydrates have the following functions. They serve as energy storage molecules, have structural and immunological functions, act as signaling molecules, serve as receptors on cell surfaces, help in the detection of diseases, function as an anticoagulant, and are associated with the regulation of cell growth. They also act as precursor molecules. Thank you for watching this lecture on the structure and function of complex carbohydrates.